Good day to everyone. Let's design a power transfer switch to start and load a three-phase generator automatically when the mains power is interrupted. We require two magnetic contactors for mains and generator power, and a phase failure relay to monitor any fault on incoming three-phase mains supply. Two time relays and a DPDT relay, operational with mains supply, and another time relay powered from generator side. Timer and a relay, operational with 12 volts battery for generator automatic start connection. For the automatic stop of the generator, another set of timer and relay is needed, operating with 12 volt battery. A 12 volt time relay is needed to monitor generator start failures. Two 5-pin single pole double throw relays are required to control the starting and stopping of the generator. You need two switches to supply 230 volts to the control circuit. 12 volt DC power for timers and relays will be supplied from the generator battery. Pulling the timers and relays out of their bases reveals the numbered terminals. Three-phase 400 volt power lines from the mains, connected through the contactor to the load. Three generator power connection lines also connected to the load through the other magnetic contactor. Now, connect three phase lines of the grid to the phase failure relay. Connect a phase line and the neutral line to the two-pole breaker. From the breaker, phase line is connected to the common port of the phase failure relay. Normally open port on the left side will connect to the number 7 terminal of the grid side, which is timer number 1. Number 7 is connected to the common port number 8. Neutral line is connected to the number 2 of the timer number 1. Outlet terminal number 6 goes to the number 7 port of the DPDT relay. Number 7 should also be connected to common port number 8. The neutral line on the grid side is connected to number 2 of the relay. Output port number 6 will go through the normally closed auxiliary contact points of the generator side contactor to port number 7 of timer number 2. Number 7 is connected to common port number 8. The neutral line on the grid side is connected to number 2. Output terminal number 6 is connected to the A1 coil end of the mains contactor. The neutral line on the mains side is connected to the coil end A2. On the generator side, bring a phase line to the double pole breaker. The neutral line should be connected to the breaker from the generator side. From the switch, the phase line is connected to the number 1 common terminal of the relay. Output port number 4 of the relay is connected to terminal number 7 of the timer relay on the generator side. Number 7 is also connected to common port number 8. The neutral line on the generator side is connected to port number 2 on the timer. The line from terminal number 6 is then taken through the normally closed auxiliary contact points on the main contactor to the A1 coil end of the generator side contactor. The neutral line on the generator side should be connected to the coil end A2. Connect generator side control power to the A1 and A2 coil ends of the 5-pin SPDT relays. The line from the positive end of the battery must first pass through the normally closed auxiliary contact points of the mains contactor before connecting it to port number 7 of the generator start timer. Terminal number 7 must be connected to common port number 8. Connect the negative end of the battery to port number 2 on the timer. Connect the number 6 timer output terminal to the number 7 port of the starter relay. Port number 2 is connected to the negative end. You also need to connect number 6 to number 7 of the start fail detection timer relay. The generator starting point connection line passes through three relays. It is through 1 and 3 points of the starter relay, 1 and 4 points of the start failure detection relay, and through the common and normally closed points of the SPDT relay that operates through the generator run signal. To stop the generator, take the line from the positive end of the battery, and it should go through the normally closed auxiliary contact points of the generator contactor. This line must also pass through the normally open auxiliary contact points of the mains contactor before connecting to port number 7 of the generator stop timer. Port number 7 should be connected to common port number 8. The negative end of the battery should be connected to port number 2 on the timer. Next, connect port number 6 of the generator stop timer to port number 7 of the generator stop relay. Connect the negative end of the battery to port number 2 of the relay. Now, the stop connection points of the generator, where the stop push button or stop key is connected, will be connected through two relays. The generator stop points are connected through the 1 and 3 normally open contact points of the stop relay, and through the common terminal and the normally open terminal of the SPDD relay, which is for generator stop control. Now, let's see how this system starts the generator automatically.
Whether it is for a small startup company or for a giant in the business world, we are here to provide you with the best service. We will make the website of your dreams come true, with very reasonable prices. Contact Greenlight Web Solutions on WhatsApp or email us for more information. Thank you.
Neutral connections and battery negative connections are intact, for easy reference. When three-phase grid power is available, the common port of the phase failure relay receives control power. PFR will receive three-phase power, also at the same time. The phases must be in the correct sequence, and with no undervoltage or overvoltage, for the PFR to allow control power through its normally open port, to timer number 1. This timer relay is to delay the mains supply to the load, when the generator is on load. Before removing the load from the generator, a delay of 3 to 5 minutes is set here, with the assumption that the grid power will remain stable from then on. The relay is energized after this delay period. Normally open points 8 and 6 will now be closed, allowing control power to timer number 2. This timer is to maintain a time lapse, preventing the load from getting power from the grid immediately after generator supply is removed from the load. The 2 to 3 second blackout, during the switch to grid power from generator power, is due to this safety time delay. The control supply to the operating coil of the mains contactor A1, now enables the three-phase supply to the load. Along the way, this control power line to A1 passed through the normally closed auxiliary contact points of the generator contactor, allowing safety interlocking between two magnetic contactors. When the main power supply fails, the normally open auxiliary contact points on the mains contactor will be closed. This allows power from the 12-volt battery to pass through it to the generator start timer. Delay period of 2 to 3 seconds is set on this timer to stop unnecessary starting of the generator during momentary power cuts on some areas. After this delay period, the start relay and the start fail detection timer are energized. Terminals 1 and 3, normally open on the start relay, are now closed, but points 1 and 4 normally closed on the start fail timer still remain closed, until the set delay time is reached. The common terminals of the 5-pin SPDD relays are connected to their normally closed terminals, since they are not yet powered. Now the generator start push button points are connected through the loop created through these three relays. When the starter connection points of the generator are connected together, it energizes the starter solenoid connected to the starter motor, and starts cranking the engine after engaging with the flywheel. Also at the same time, it energizes the engine stop solenoid and opens the fuel supply to the fuel pump to run the engine. Although the starter motor disengages after the generator starts, the engine stop solenoid will still hold itself in its energized state. When the generator stop connection is activated, the engine stop solenoid deactivates and the fuel supply is shut off to stop the engine. Usually the starter motor should disengage after 2 to 3 seconds of operation, as the generator must start within this period. The generator will reach its normal speed and voltage in a total of 3 to 4 seconds. Therefore, we can use the 5-pin SPDD relay to stop the engine cranking, and disengage the starter motor through the generator side control power line, which acts here as the generator run signal. The normally closed points of this relay will open and break the starting loop, disengaging the starter motor in 3 to 4 seconds. If the generator did not start in 3 to 4 seconds, the scenario is different. The SPDT relay will not receive control power to interrupt the starter motor operating loop. For the safety of the generator, we must stop cranking after 5 to 6 seconds. To stop cranking, we can set a delay time of 5 to 6 seconds on the starting failure detection relay. This timing relay is activated at the same time that the engine cranking is initiated. So after this delay period, the start loop is interrupted via contact points 1 and 4 normally closed, which are now open. Then you need to check the starting system and the battery for defects, before reconnecting it to the automated system. 3-phase power is now available at terminals L1, L2, and L3 of the generator contactor. Also, the generator side timer relay is powered via normally closed terminals 1 and 4 on the DPDT relay, which has not yet received control power. This timer delays the generator, taking full load immediately after starting. General condition for generator loading from a cold start is to keep it idling for 10 to 15 seconds before allowing full load on it. The 10 second time setting is sufficient here to allow full load on the generator. With the addition of a 2 second start delay and a 3 second start time, generator power will be available on load after around 15 to 17 seconds when mains power fails. After this 10 second delay, the generator contactor gets control power from the generator powered timer, and then 3-phase power to the load. Here also the interlocking of the contactors is provided, taking the control line through the normally closed auxiliary contact points on the main side contactor.
Hi, thank you for watching this video. Now we are also on Facebook. Follow us and like our page, Electro Academy on Facebook. Thank you.
When grid power becomes available again, PFR will allow control power to timer number 1 through its normally open port, which is now closed. Although a 3 to 5 minute delay on this timer is recommended, a 1 minute delay is sufficient to assume that the grid supply is stable enough to replace generator power on the load. After this delay period, the DPDT relay is energized. Now, with the opening of 1 and 4 normally closed contact points, the generator contactor loses control power, and therefore stops 3-phase power to the load. Note that although 3-phase power from the generator is removed from the load, 3-phase power is available at the generator contactor terminals L1, L2, and L3, until the generator engine is stopped. So, with the powered up relay, timer number 2 also gets control power through its normally open ports, which are closed now. Timer number 2 will delay the power supply to the grid contactor by 2 to 3 seconds after the generator is unloaded. As explained earlier, this safety time lapse is to prevent grid power from being transferred to the load immediately after the generator is unloaded. The load is receiving 3-phase power through the grid side contactor now. With it, the normally closed auxiliary contact points of the grid side contactor will open, causing the generator start timer, start relay, and start fail timer relay to lose their 12-volt supply. At the same time, the normally open auxiliary contact points on the mains contactor will close. Since the normally closed auxiliary contact points of the generator contactor also remain closed, a path is created for the generator stop timer to receive 12-volt power through those points. Normally, after running at full load, the generator should idle for about 5 minutes before stopping. With only an average load on the generator, it will be acceptable to keep 3 minutes on this shutdown timer. After this delay period, the engine stop relay is activated, causing normally open ports 1 and 3 to close. This will create a loop to join the generator stop connection points via the 5-pin SPDT relay and the stop relay. With it, the engine stop solenoid, which opens the fuel supply line to the engine, is deactivated and the fuel supply to the engine is closed. After the generator stops, control power to the SPDT relays will be removed, disturbing the engine stop connection loop. However, it will allow the generator to be started or stopped manually, using normal push-button switch or a key switch, to carry out maintenance or repair work on it. But be sure to manually turn off the generator control breaker, to prevent it from automatically loading during a power outage. I hope you have a clear idea of how automatic starting and stopping of a three-phase generator is done when a power outage occurs. If you think this video is useful for you, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.